Hello everybody, Dr. Carlo Ojed. In this video, we're going to be talking about the unboxing of this device called the Cellscope. It was a device designed out of Georgia Tech, apparently. It's been out for about a year, mostly in trials, but finally is available for purchase through their website. You do have to be in the healthcare and provide evidence of licensure and stuff to actually buy this. But this is actually awesome, pretty cool stuff. Essentially what it does is a box that links to the camera and can be used as an otoscope to examine the ears. The advantage of it is, of course, by having the camera, it gives you the option to save pictures to show the parents what you're seeing. It also, if you're a medical provider, there's a link to HIPAA-compliant web app, so you can save studies, you can follow up, load follow-up images on the same patient. But not only that, it eventually is going to be made available to the individuals, patients, so that they can purchase it and they can acquire images to send to their doctors to be diagnosed with otitis media and stuff like that. So let's go ahead and open the box. The box includes the Cellscope. This one is particularly compatible with 5S, which is a problem for me because I uploaded to the iPhone 6 Plus, which is not compatible with it. I did have the iPhone 5S left over, which I was using as an Apple TV at home, but for the purpose of this video, I unhooked it from the Apple TV, and I'm gonna be showing you guys what this does. The optical otoscope attachment, the storage container for the specs, for the tips, and then pediatric tips and whatnot, a little cable to prevent it from falling to the ground, that kind of a thing. All right, so everything came out. This is the actual container box. It says install the app, which is Oto, cellscope.com.download, also available in the App Store. So it looks like a regular case. It's got that hard feeling to it. I like when they're a little bit more rubbery. But this is what's important. It has a special attachment for the light. The other cool thing is that it does include this here. That's so you can attach an insufflator so you can do movement of the tympanic membrane with putting air in and out. So looks like it goes like that. And it locks in place. So that's cool because then you can take it out when not in use and still be able to use your cell phone as everything else. So you put it on and you're ready to use it. Now I'm not gonna download the app. I'm just gonna try, this is how I would actually use it on a practical basis. It's just like that, use that portion of it. I wonder if, yeah, you can zoom it in and stuff. So let's say I'm gonna examine an ear. Then I would just kind of put my finger in front of it, and then I could see the magnified finger on the camera there. So that. So essentially, you would put the spec for the ear. There we go. This is a pediatric, got the small hole on it. Bigger one for the adult. And then you would stick it to the ear and take a picture. So if I do video, would it actually, yeah, it does, but let's see if I put the flash on. Yes, then that activates the light source. So yeah, that's pretty cool right there. So if I'm right over that, I hope you're being able to see this. You can see the, cool. So I'm just gonna put video on and go into my ear and see what we end up with. So I'm going into my ear and kind of going up and down, going a little deep. All right. So we're gonna play that video and see what we have. Yeah, just right now I'm pointing to the ear canal. Ooh, got some wax. I'm gonna go to the bathroom and clean that up. So that's not good. All right, let's do another one. And this one I'm gonna point a little bit up. Let's activate the flash on, video start. So, Let's see if we get a better image this time. Yes, definitely you cannot do this blindly because you won't get any kind of view at the what you want to see. All I'm getting is ear canal stuff, so that's not good. So pretty happy with the image it produces. Obviously I would use this on video mode most likely. Turn the flash on so you can actually see. I do not like that when you're doing this, it flips the image upside down. You see that? Let me see if I can focus on that. I like the focus features do work. But see how confusing it is to try to get it on? Like, I'm going down, but the letters are going, you know, they're upside down. Now, that shouldn't play a big difference when you're looking at the ear sideways like that. But it does. I mean, it's confusing. And you're kind of like, you want to see up, but you actually have to aim down, and it's going to mess it up. The other thing I don't like is the fact that it's a $299 little device for a plastic thing. You know, is it worth it? Yes, because the alternative is Welch Allyn makes one that I have that hooks up to a computer. So you have to have the computer. It hooks up to the actual ENT kit, but it's hard to, because you can only see the image in the computer over here, and then you have to be aiming at the ear and stuff, and you have to have a computer and the whole thing. So this is very portable. You can unlink it, save this in your pocket, and then when you're ready to use, you put it back in. What I don't like is I don't use the iPhone 5 anymore, so I have a 6 Plus, and it doesn't click. Eventually, they're going to make one, but what? I'm going to buy another $300 attachment so I can use this? What about if by the time that one comes out, I'm already an iPhone 7? So the company needs to do a little bit better at catching up to the times and new phones and whatnot, or make a device that is actually adjustable that somehow I can put in here, and it's going to work anyway. Now, this one has a box and stuff, so I'm sure it won't, but if I were to just put it here and put the flash on, you know, does it work? So I put the flash on. Can I actually make the camera go in and work? Well, maybe I could. There you go. You can see a little bit of something there, but that's a real problem. It'd be better if they redesign the attachment so it's like a clip-on, and it would clip onto the device. But the problem is Apple keeps moving the camera around, so even if they did that, there's no guarantee that's gonna work. So that's the one thing I don't like about this. So I'm gonna end up having to carry two devices, you know, my phone and an old phone to use only as an otoscope. It's still worth it because, like I said, the option is buying the Welch Allyn application, which is $800, and it attaches to a computer, so you have to have a computer, and the computer has to be a PC. I'm a Mac user, so it's just a lot of different stuff. But I'm looking forward to obtaining some pictures, getting some video, some ear exams, and sharing those with you through my website, the EDXit video. So what do you think? Any comments on this? Obviously this new technology and attachments and how this is going to help medicine and telemedicine for that matter, about how moms are going to be able to take some pictures or video of a kid's ear, send it to their doctor and get some telemedicine at 2 in the morning. That's pretty cool stuff. I hope you enjoy this video and we'll see you in the next one.